Hey, thanks for clicking on the extended version of my cast interviews for Jean-Marc Vallée's new film, Demolition. Jake Gyllenhaal, man, he can't do any wrong. He is really good in this film, plays a husband whose wife is killed, and he essentially unravels in a really interesting way. Had a chance to sit down with Jake, his co-stars Naomi Watts and Chris Cooper, and a young star out of Canada who I think stole the show.
Dear Champion Vending Company, this letter is in regards to vending machine 714 located in St. Andrew's Hospital, which should have given me peanut M&Ms. Regrettably, it didn't.
When was the last time you actually wrote a letter?
I actually write handwritten letters a lot.
You do?
I do, actually, yeah.
See, why
not? Not like long form, huge handwritten letters, but definitely I write notes. I have like note cards. I write a lot of notes. I really appreciate them when I get them from people.
Yeah.
And so regardless of what I expect other people to appreciate from me, I like to kind of put that feeling back out there for someone else.
Have you ever written one to complain about something?
Yeah, I wrote when I was a kid. I remember they discontinued Chicken Littles from Kentucky Fried Chicken.
Yeah.
And I wrote them a complaint letter because I don't really know what that was about. They're not just tenders, though. Chicken Littles were like, they were like little, like soft.
Nuggets?
Little soft buns, but like, yeah, but they were like tenders, but like in a bun with like a ridiculously horrible amount of mayonnaise on them, but they were like really, they were an experience. And
I feel like I'm bringing back some
like
bad memories.
They're not bad. No. They're good memories. Yeah. They're good memories.
You play a customer service representative. What is the worst customer service experience you've ever had?
I think I've made some complaints, and mostly at airports, I think.
Yeah, I was going to say, that's the one place I think everybody...
And you're just, you know, dealing with a level of tension, aren't you, when you're at an airport?
She's gone.
What I loved about this movie, and I think everybody can relate whether they've lost somebody close to them or not, is grief really does come in different forms. And I loved the fact that your character, while established early on, isn't the hugest fan of Jake's character. He really tries everything he can to give him the benefit of the doubt with how he's grieving.
You put it in a nutshell. This is a whole study on grief. We're repeating ourselves here, but it is a study on grief and how people grieve differently, and you have to accept that. You have to. I think it can hurt a lot of families. Whether one person expects the other to grieve in the same way, and that can shatter people.
What are we doing again?
We're taking apart my marriage.
I know that you get to demolish this house behind us with Jake. You play baseball, I read, so I'm guessing was your swing with a hammer better than his?
I don't know. He's pretty athletic. I think we were, yeah, no, but...
Are you being diplomatic?
I'm being very diplomatic. Okay. No, we had so much fun, though. I mean, it was actually my first day filming. I walked on the set and was handed a sledgehammer. I was like, oh, all right, let's do this. You know, and you know, it's the kind of thing you never actually think, you know, you're going to be standing on one side of a room with a mini crowbar and somebody's going to tell you, all right, now chuck it into that flat screen TV. But it happened.
I guess I don't really use a hammer often, but I would imagine that you're actually really sore the next day from doing this all day.
I was very sore. It was actually 2 days.
Oh, my
and
God.
And the thing is, all of it's real. Like, there's no breakaway glass. There's no fake. Like, that countertop that we break into, completely real. And so, I mean, you're swinging, like, as hard as you can. And it's, I mean, it would be like... actually just demolishing a house because that's what we were doing. So yes, there I was definitely, okay, here we go.
I was going to say, the next day you come, don't make me even lift my arms for any scene.
Just, yeah.
I can't even smoke like my character. Is there anything that you actually would love to take apart just to see how it worked?
I was going to say the government, and then I think I'm going to...
Although that is a good
I was
going
to say, like, campaign finance reform. Okay. I don't think I'm going to go there.
Come on, let's keep it real superficial. Yeah, I got 4 minutes with you.
Oh, you mean like,
yeah, like
right.
Stupid stuff.
anything I'd like to take apart? I mean, not really. Like, not really.
Yeah.
It's just not a want. It's not a want of mine. But
I'm with you.
I do like to know what's going on with people, you know? Mm-hmm. I do like to know whether people are, you know, what makes people tick. Mm-hmm. So that's why I like to do what I do. So I act because I like to kind of look inside and see what's going on and try and figure it out and recreate it one way or another. So that might be part, but not in the physical world, not so much.
Have you ever wanted to take something apart just to put it back together?
I've done it many, many times.
Wait, is this a guy thing? Like what? Sure, what have you taken apart?
It's a guy thing. My survival job when I lived in New York was doing small demolition and as a carpenter. I'd go to people's Upper East Side apartments, wealthy folks up there, and tear down the old maid's quarters walls or put in a kitchen or a dry bar or wet bar, and I knocked down many, many walls.
Do those people know that Chris Cooper knocked down their wall and put that dry bar in there?
I hope they do by now.
If you could actually destroy something to see how it works and put it back together, what would that be?
A car. I think.
You would do it?
I think that would be cool. Yeah. Just to dismantle the engine and kind of see how everything works, because it's the kind of thing I don't think many people think, like, okay, well, what's moving it forward?
For real right now? There's some random guy eating in our house.
The man's wife just died. Have some compassion.
I know you've got two boys. The character he plays, it's not that uncommon to see teenage boys angry and rebellious. Does that make you nervous at all when your boys get to be teenagers? Were you nervous at all?
I think you worry for them, you know, from day one. As toddlers, as, you know, little kids, I'm sure it'll happen when they're teenagers. Yeah, the worries just change.
There aren't many things that make me nervous to the point where I literally, my back is super sweaty and it's just gross.
Yeah.
Dancing in public is one of them.
Totally.
And you not only have to do it in public, I'm guessing, were those even extras? Did you guys just go shoot that?
Yeah, we just shot that. But actually, the only thing that will make your back sweaty and gross is actually dancing in public, just so you know. So either way you go about it, you're going to get a sweaty, gross back.
Did you get one?
Yeah, definitely. It was nerve-wracking. Like, Jean-Marc had told me he wanted to do that. It wasn't in the script initially, and then he said, I want to do that. And I'm going to kind of pull it on you when I want you to do it. So every day was kind of like, when's the dancing through Lower Manhattan going to happen, you know? And the way he shoots is really off the cuff, you know, you just go and you shoot stuff. So one day he just gave me an iPod with headphones and he was like, put them on, like, it's time to dance. And I had no choice but to do it, otherwise I'd be keeping everybody waiting and we'd be wasting a lot of money, you know? So I just had to dance.
You've played Jake's father before years ago, obviously,
yeah.
October Sky, another great movie. Mm. How has he changed?
He's just gotten better and better and more intense, you know, and he's still a sweetheart.
Repairing the human heart is like repairing an automobile. You have to take everything apart. Just examine everything.
Have you ever gone through that rut where you're not feeling, there's something missing, something big?
For a good while, things occur. And that's, you know, it's why I related to Phil. You go through a situation like this and there's no catharsis, you know, there's no end. Some days you handle it well and some days it can devastate you.
Why do you want to go back and do it again? Go through it
again? I just felt like I had given, it was time to. I've never dealt with this subject in a film or as a character. And enough time has passed for me that I felt it was time to, you know, deal with it.
Did it help?
Like I say, never ends.
Do you think it's too late to put it all back together?
I hope you enjoyed my cast interviews for the film Demolition. Don't forget to like us on Facebook, Harkins Theaters, for your movie news, promotions, and giveaways. And of course, I say it all the time, I'll see you at the movies.